So now we will study what how we will derive the families of filter bank out of this R. So the family of filter banks. So now if I look at a generalized expression which according to like the ref, I will use some standard references. Have to use some reference according to which I will name the filter. Okay. So first, if I take the signal X of Z, I pass it through a low pass high pass pair, and try to analyze the signal. Analyzing means just splitting it. Even in Fourier, you remember the analysis equation is where we are trying to obtain the coefficients associated with each signal. So we are trying to analyze it. Analysis means we are splitting it in frequency. Okay. So when I analyze it, this low pass, high pass filter, let this filter be H0 of Z, let this filter be H1 of Z. Then I pass this to this filter bank. Then and followed by a decimation operation. This completes my, what we say, analysis. And then what we do, we again pass it through an upsampler. This is channel. After passing through channel, we again pass it through upsampler followed by another pair of filters, which let me name it as G0Z and G1Z, and again followed by an adder. Now if I look at the desirability of a system, now just first look at the system. It has this side, analysis side, where we are splitting the signal, and the synthesis side where we are synthesizing or trying to find some sort of signal representation and the output. So this is what we call synthesis side. And this is downsampler and or decimation, and this is upsampler. So now let us try to understand how this works. Okay. But first of all, let me write some conditions of which kind of system we should move ahead with. After all, this whole problem will be reduced to this exit passing through some system which gives me some output riser. And now if I look at this simplified, or this is black box. If I look at this simplified system, the best kind of system which I can design must be something like that YZ is some constant times X of Z, and definitely the alias must be multiplied with 0. This is the kind of system we are approaching, and this is what will lead to form this condition when we do some stuff will lead to Dabochi's wavelet pairs. Okay. Dabochi's wavelets or filter bank, this recursively which we will get. So now, not recursively, in some forms we will get. Okay. But now let us try to understand how this thing will be reduced. So first let's try to put some time and effort to understand this type of filter bank structure. So now as I move this point, let me write 1 and this point 2. At 1, let me first do this side. This signal will be X. And let me not write ZZ every time. Okay. So XH0, this signal here will be. Now as soon as it passes through this decimation operation, what will happen? It will get this half x zero or x of minus z, फिर x of z, h zero z plus, and this half factor will remain plus x of minus z, h of minus z. This is what will be the stuff at point number one. Similarly at point number two, just some variation of the things. When I get through an upsampler, the upsampler will again see. Now what will upsampler do? It will scale the time axis in sense that the sampling time will be multiplied by 2. So the delay will be reduced. So this half-half factor will again go. So this is what will happen at point this, whatever this point be. Let me name this one, this point 2, this now point 3. So at 3 the equation will be something like this. When I multiply with g naught z, that's simple enough. Just multiplication of g naught z. So this is what comes at point 4. Similarly from here, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, point, anyways, 5, this 6, this 7, and this 8. When this signal passes through this also, the equation obtained will be similar. Xz, h, here 1z, plus x of minus z, h1 of minus z, times g, 1z. And then I will add both of them. So the final output or y of z is sum of both. When I add this and this, what I get is 1 second. So you remember the what we had explained, how should we get a desirable system, how the system should be. The system should be something where this yz is just some constant times x of z. This is very important, which you need to understand. So how can we, so just let me write the terms which are with x z. Let me write it as some form. Let me write it as some, what do we tell, a of z into x of z plus v of z into x of minus z, where this a of z, if you just try to just rearrange the previous equations, you will very simply get it as half of g0 or h0 g0 plus g1 or h1 times g1 of h, or what we say, let me write it as full only, h0 of z, g0 of z plus h1 of minus z and g1 of z. This is what you will get. And the v of z which you will get will be equal to half times h0 of minus z, g0 of z plus h1 of minus z, g1 of z. So just tell me this all complex, don't try to worry about all this stuff, okay? Just look at this equation, this final equation. This a times, this az times x of z plus v of z times x of minus z. This term a of z must be equal to some constant, and this must be equal to 0, and this is what will lead us to the final, this the series of Dabhousie's theorem. So if this has to be constant, it means that they must in some ways form some sort of an arrangement so that it becomes constant. And along with this, if this has to be zero, then this has to be zero. This will lead us to a form. This will lead us to a form which will make us understand the crux of the stuff. So just tell me, if I want some xz is equal to constant, some this what we want constant, a of z is equal to constant. How should the a of n be equal to? A of n must be equal to something like an impulse, because the inverse Z transform of a constant is equal to an impulse. And this is something which we will consider. Okay, just understand this thing. So let me write this as concept number one, which we will use in this overall process. And the second concept which we will get, this B of Z is equal to zero. And what does it mean? Just tell me. This means that G naught, this H naught of minus Z, G naught of Z plus H1 of minus Z, G naught of G1 of Z is equal to zero. So this we earlier told that this A of Z is equal to some constant is equation 1, and this has to be zero. So if this has to be zero, if you put this into this equation, what you will get is something like this. Okay, G naught of Z, if you put it, I'm just directly stating the result, upon G1 of Z is equal to opposite H1 of minus Z divided by H0 of Z minus Z. So the best choice in this case would be, let me take equal to some factor, okay? Let me tell some k of Z, okay? And this also some k of Z equal to. So this, taking the g of Z and g1 of Z in this form is what will form. The previous concept that b of Z is equal has to be 0 is the concept 2, and this will be concept number 3. On the basis of these three concepts, we will move on with the, we will study the exact exam, this way, the example of how we are deriving the Darboux wavelet in the next lecture. So for now, so far so good.